Now back to Eyes on the Game with Helen Yee, the only female sports host in Las Vegas. Go online to HelenMYee.com and follow on Twitter at Helen Yee Sports on NBC Sports 920 The Game.
Hey guys, welcome back to the show. Like I always say, and I don't know if I either don't say it enough or I say it too much, but I'm proud to be born and raised here in Las Vegas. And it is, in my opinion, the fight capital of the world, which is why I'm very excited to have the next guest join me on the show. He's a kickboxer and undefeated heavyweight boxer in such an exciting division right now, the heavyweight division. I have Jarrell Miller joining me on the line right now. What's going on, Jarrell?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Great. How are you? Thank you for your time.
Yeah, a little busy, but, you know, got put some time to, you know, talk to media and take care of business.
Well, I really appreciate that, and I won't take up too much of your time because guys like Deontay Wilder, and Deontay was supposed to fight on May 21st against Alexander Povetkin, but then Povetkin tested positive for meldonium. What do you think about the recent incident that happened?
I mean, it's nothing that's new. I mean, a lot of these Europeans are known for juicing up. It's just that they just don't get caught because they fight a lot. There's no doubt in my mind that, you know, I know Vladimir and Vitaly had got caught in the amateurs for it. No doubt in my mind that Anthony Joshua's on something. And I mean, from the amateurs of being 218, 220 now, a year and a half later, he's 245 and change. So, I mean, a lot of European guys are doing it. You know, it's just that they're just not getting caught because they're fighting on their home soil. So, I mean, I think it was a lot of testing that caught Povetkin, and I hope all of them get caught. You know what I mean? It's just, you know, American fighters are just superb fighters, and right now we're like, geez, what? But like I said, you know, I'm the guy on the top of the pile, and I'm coming from my spot. So it's a matter of time.
Yeah, and, I mean, you are undefeated, but you mentioned Anthony Joshua, and I did read that you had some words for him and also for Charles Martin before he beat Charles for the IBF heavyweight title. Why do you not like Anthony Joshua?
He's definitely an overhyped job. You know, he doesn't have the experience, but they wasn't planning to fight any American fighters anymore. There's a lot of hype, but, you know, they had the money off the table, and they went and jumped to Joshua Anthony, and now they're fighting guys that's, like, not even in the top 10 to I guess, you know, uphold his title right now. So he's not fighting no real risk right now, and they're going to make as much money as they can and hide in England. But sooner or later, they're going to have to step out of their comfort zone and fight somebody who, you know what I mean? But nobody's calling my name, that's for sure, you know. But, you know, Matt, like I said, everything's a matter of time right now, and it's just one round at a time.
So do you think they're afraid of you?
Yeah, most definitely. A lot of top 10 guys are afraid of me, and some of them don't risk because, you know, fighting me right now, there isn't a lot of money in the table, which definitely makes sense boxing-wise. Mm-hmm. Like I said before, I just got to keep earning my stripes and work my way up the ranks and just get the publicity and get my name out there and just staying focused, man. Just, you know, I mean, it's hard. Being a boxer is definitely hard in this day and age because there's some of the things you can't do other than box and get punched in the face. But, you know, with the grace of God and just one day at a time and doing it for so long, like, this is what I want to do is just, you know, knocking distractions out of the way and getting in and doing my job.